Welcome, everyone. No one can predict the future with certainty, especially in the rapidly changing world of military technology. Recently, the US Air Force made a surprising move by temporarily suspending its sixth generation fighter jet program, the Next Generation Air Dominance, or NGAD. This decision surprised many, especially since the program was considered the key to US air dominance in the future. However, Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall asserted that the suspension was a necessary step to review the design and operational concept of the aircraft that is expected to replace the F-22 Raptor. This decision has raised many questions and speculations. Is this a sign that the NGAD program is facing major problems? Kendall revealed that there is a possibility that the new fighter jet will be optionally piloted, or even unmanned. This marks a major shift in US military strategy, which may indicate their readiness to face a new era of air combat with more advanced and autonomous technology. However, the decision to delay the development of NGAD also shows uncertainty within the US military. With threats from China and Russia increasing, this delay could be seen as a risky move. Is the US playing with fire by risking its military superiority? Or is it perhaps a wise move to avoid a major mistake and ensure that the sixth generation fighter is truly fit for future needs? Moreover, the NGAD program is not just about one aircraft. It is a family of systems that includes manned aircraft and autonomous drones called Collaborative Combat Aircraft, CCA. These drones are designed to work alongside manned fighters carrying out strike missions, reconnaissance missions, or even acting as decoys to deceive the enemy. The idea may seem futuristic, but it also raises questions about its effectiveness and cost. The program is already costing billions of dollars, and the US Air Force is requesting an additional $3.3 billion for its development in fiscal year 2025. But with costs continuing to balloon, there are concerns that the program may be too much of a burden on the US defense budget, especially with other major projects such as the B-21 bomber and the Sentinel ballistic missile also requiring significant funding. The controversy escalated when Northrop Grumman, one of the largest military contractors, announced that it would not bid to be the prime contractor for NGAD, leaving Lockheed Martin and Boeing as the main contenders. Is this a sign of deeper problems with the program? Or perhaps Northrop Grumman sees more risks than opportunities in the project? With all of this said, the big question remains, will this temporary halt help strengthen the NGAD program and ensure future US air dominance, or is it an early sign of impending failure? One thing is for sure, the world is watching closely and the decisions made today will have long-term implications for US national security and the global balance of power. Amidst this uncertainty, one thing remains clear: the US must continue to innovate and adapt quickly to maintain its military edge. Otherwise, it could find itself left behind in an increasingly competitive military technology race. What do you think? Is the NGAD program salvageable, or are we witnessing the beginning of the end of US air dominance? Leave your thoughts in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video.